inside the mortar, the mortar will be dirty. He doesn't want to get his uniform dirty, so it's easier to have a pair of flannel sleeves in there, all natural material that we use, to go ahead and clean it out. He's also handed a wiper. And the wiper, you see, he put on top of that steak is there. That's also the use to clean out the mortar going, so you can make sure it's clean. It's a little dry here, so excuse me. All right, once everybody has their implements and stuff, the gunner's going to reach into his haversack and pull out a gunner's level. The gunner's level is made of brass, has feet on it with a little arrow. He puts this on the top of the mortar. He needs to get his line of metal or his line of sight. He says there's a little spirit level on there, just pretty much like if you were using a level. You go there, find out where the exact level, exact top of that gun is, and he'll mark it with a piece of soapstone or chalk. Alright, because when these mortars are put in here, they're not exactly level. We want to make sure it's level. Remember, we're lining it up through here. Now, what happens here, if you look at the front of the spike, you can see a rope hanging here. That's the gunner's line. That's the gunner's line. Alright, once this is done, he's ready to go ahead and start loading the cannon. Alright, I'm loading here two men. We'll get a hand spike with the four man to go with the tongs and go back to the ball. They'll set the ball, fill it with powder, put the fuse in. Number three man is going ahead and wiping out, sweeping off the platform, make sure there's gunpowder there. The number one man with a spoon scraper reaches inside the mortar, tries to get out any heavy chunks that's there, pulls it out with a spoon. The number one man will reach in there and he'll wipe out anything that's left over from before. Notice the four and two man are coming forward with the ball. The ball's hooked up to a set of tongs. That's set there. The gunner will now retrieve the powder that's inside there. The powder's brought out from the linen bag. Number four man wipes off the bottom of the ball. We don't want anything there. He goes ahead and he pours the powder in. The powder's actually poured out fully inside the mortar. Now, we're not going to shoot 4 pounds of powder with this ball. The ball you see here does look like a mortar round, does look like a Tennessee round, except it's not. It's something I fashioned. Go ahead, weighs about 5 pounds. We have nicknamed him Mr. Wilson. So Mr. Wilson is then set inside the mortar. Now there's a piece of aluminum foil there that was not around in 1860. This is one of the things for different. When Mr. Wilson goes flying out of here, I do not want to catch him on fire. This protects Mr. Wilson from the gunpowder charge. Now normally when the mortar round's put in there, it's put in so the fuse is facing out. A lot of you think, well, should be able to catch fire. It's facing out. When the fire comes around, if everything works right, it hits the gunpowder compound in here and it'll burn down to where it was cut. Number four man is now bringing back the gunner's line. Now the gunner will take this and he'll put that over the two pointing stakes here. Now what he said, remember that little chalk line he put on the top? Well, now he's going to line this up all the way through with that stake up on top. Where he wants it. Once it's in position, the gunner will go ahead and move to front. He'll give the command ready. Everybody will go in their positions. Now, each and every time the mortar's fired, they have to go through this drill all the time. They accept the 20 point stakes. They'll always be there. Alright, the command ready. The four and one man will move to the rear of the mortar. The number three man will set up the friction primer into the vent. The gunner will put up a little deflector. The deflector was not there during the war between the states. Time is here for key things. Now we want that friction primer to deflect down into the ground. That's why we don't put anybody up behind the mortar. We have to test that friction primer to actually go up to the wall. This way it goes directly there. And then once this is done, the gunner will move off to the side.